In this video, we are going to explore the various ways that Drupal provides to allow account registration. So to begin, in the admin toolbar, hover over configuration, then people, and then click on account settings. Here at this page, you can see the various options for the registration and cancellation of accounts. For us, this is going to be a community-based site. We want to reduce the amount of friction that visitors have to create accounts. So under the registration and cancellation section, under who can register accounts, click on visitors. And then let's unselect the require email verification. We can always change these later if we wish or need to. I am going to keep the remaining defaults the same. And then take a scan over the various emails that Drupal will send on your behalf. Notice the use of text within square brackets. These are what are called tokens, and we'll learn more about tokens later. But one thing to notice that Drupal does take security seriously. It does say after setting your password, you will be able to log in at the site login URL that's automatically generated when the email is sent, and it'll say your username is this. It'll give them their username they chose, and password, it says your password. It does not provide a text password in the email for security purposes. Feel free to scan the remaining emails if you wish, but for now, just verify that visitors can register themselves. Email verification is not required. Leave all the default emails as they were and click Save Configuration. Now that we have allowed visitors to register themselves without email verification, let's see what the form looks like. In a new incognito or private window, open up the home page. And in the menu, you will see a login link. So click Login. If you do not see the login link, just go to /user/login, and you'll be presented with this page. This allows users to type their username and password and log in, or they can create a new account, right? They can type in their email address, a username, a password. We're allowing them to upload a picture if they wish, and allowing them to choose whether or not other site members can contact them. So although we could create a new user account this way, I'm going to show you another way that administrators can create accounts. So let's do that now. I'm going to close this incognito or private window and going back to our Drupal site signed in as the user one. So in the admin toolbar, click on people. As expected, it shows the list of users currently on the site, of which I am the only one. And notice this course admin has the administrator role. But because I am user one, I have access to everything. So what we're going to do now is click on the Add User button, and let's create a new user with a content editor role. So for the email address, I'm just going to use example at example.com. Username will be editor, and the password will be the same as the username. Not a very safe password, as it shows us, it's a weak. Confirm password, same thing, editor. Make sure to set the status to active. Blocked accounts cannot log into the Drupal site. Under roles, let's give this account the content editor role. We could notify the user of the new account if we wish. We don't have to. I'm going to skip over the picture for now. I am going to allow a personal contact form, and the time zone is set to my site default, which is Auckland. So when you're ready, click Create New Account. And it just says, created a new user account for editor. No email has been sent. Again, if we go back to people, you can either click on the breadcrumb here or just click on the admin toolbar for people. And now we see that we have a new user. Its username is editor. Its roles are content editor, and it has not been accessed. So let's sign in as the editor now to see what the experience is like. So in a new incognito or private window, click on home. When you've opened up your site in a new incognito tab or page, click on the login link. Or again, if that link isn't present, visit user/login. And let's sign with the username of editor. And again, the password is exactly the same. And log in. Now notice, as a content editor, I don't have as much functionality as I did with the user one account. All I can do as a content editor is I can view the content. So notice that by default, the content editing section is rendered in the front default theme. To change this to the experience that the user one has is simply a permission. So let's go back and give content editors the permission to view the administrative theme. So signed in as user one, click on people and permissions. And then we need to find, I'm going to control F here or command F. I'm going to find theme, administer themes, but we do want to give content editors the permission to view the administration theme. Again, this, as the description says, this is only used when site is configured to use a separate administrative theme on the appearance page, like our site is. So let's give the administrative theme permission to content editors and scroll down, save permissions. So now if we go back to the tab or window that is signed in to the content editor, and if we refresh the page, you'll notice that the entire theme has changed. Again, I am signed in as editor, and I have clicked on the content tab in the admin toolbar, of which is the only item I have access to as a content editor. And you can see that the content editor does in fact have the ability to view and edit content. And the same thing with media. So that's great. I'm going to log out as the editor and close the incognito window. So this concludes the video. We have added a new user called editor. But before we added the new user, we went to configuration, people, account settings, and we allowed visitors to register themselves. And we decided not to require email verification. We left all the defaults the same. And then we went to people, added a user called editor, and we made sure that we gave our new account the role of content editor. And then we tested the content editor. And then we gave the content editor an additional permission called use the admin theme, found under system, view the administration theme. Well done. This concludes the video. Happy learning.